Hey guys, welcome back to Caveman Mining. Hope everybody's well. On today's video, we are going to be testing T-Rex Miner.
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
Okay guys, so we are in the miner, and I just wanted to quickly go over the release notes for T-Rex Miner, just to show you guys, we are running Hive OS. And for this particular miner, there is an argument, and it is an important argument to understand, especially for Hive OS, that we have this quotations, light hash rate dash tune, quotations, colon, space, quotations, and then you have to put in your number argument. So for us, we are going to just simply use 4 as the recommended starting value. Now I have tried 8 and I have tried 1, and those are not efficient, and for whatever reason it bugs out on 8 and we get a pretty low hash rate on 1. So 4 seems to be the most stable argument that we can run. So I just want to show you guys the specifics of it. So let's go into the rig. You can see we're running the miner right now. These are the clocks that I'm running. Okay, so it's minus 200 on the core, very high on the memory, 2627, fans cranked up at 127, and I've got 136 watts. So again, I haven't really spent an ample amount of time playing with these clocks. I have tried the absolute core clock on this and did not get a high hash rate. I think we capped out around a 29 or 30 mega hash. So this seems to be working for me with this particular card, which again is the 3060 revision 2 light hash rate GIGABYTE EAGLE card. So yeah, this may, results may vary based on your card that you have, but let's take a quick look at the flight sheet, and we're going to edit that. You'll see our coin is ETH, wallet, we set, Hive on pool, T-Rex miner, and then we go into the setup, and this is where you go ahead and you plug in your argument. So make sure you do not copy and paste this from a website, because I found that the copy and paste, for whatever reason, I don't know if it puts an extra space or it does something funky, it throws it off. So you actually should, I recommend typing this out holistically. So you'll see, you know, character for character, colon, quotation, LHR dash, tune, quotation, semicolon, space, quotation for, quotation, okay, and then you apply that, and you apply that to all of the workers, and just make sure, okay, the version, because this is also super important, version for Hive OS that supports this T-Rex miner is 0.6-210 at 210921 is the current version, okay. And for once, okay, this is the first time this actually played a factor for me, because in the previous miners like G Miner or NB Miner, I could not get those miners to run with the 470.74 driver from NVIDIA, okay? I could only get the 460 and the 465 to run. This time around, okay, 460 did not work for me. 465 did not work for me. I actually couldn't even get them to hash with this version of T-Rex Miner. Okay, so it is a light hash rate revision 2 card. And when we look at the notes, right, you see 3060 Rev 1 cards are not given any special treatment. Well, I would put a line in there, maybe the devs, and again, I could be wrong, but maybe I'm not. The revision 2 cards, I recommend going with the 470 driver as well. So that's my recommendation. That's what's worked specifically for me. And I just want to show you guys, if we go in We refresh here, and then we'll go into the shell in a box to take a look. Now the hash rate kind of dipped a little bit, but we were up to, if you can see that, 36.30. Actually, no, that's at the share level. So let's go ahead. I want to modify this again. And I want to crank this up just slightly and see if that will work. We can get that to go up. I think at some point we were nearing 37 mega hash, which was pretty cool. The card runs a tad bit hot compared to some of the other miners, and temp wise we're at 57 degrees. And you guys can see on the wall meter, we're at a pretty steady wattage, right? We're not seeing those massive fluctuations like we were seeing with Gminer and with Lawminer. Okay, so I know Lawminer was slightly more efficient than Gminer for me at least, but this T-Rex miner is running even more efficient in terms of power level, or at least stability wise. Okay, we're getting closer to that, like more accurate reporting within the hardware. So yeah, let's take a look. Hash rate 35.24, and in the software, yep, we're reporting that hash rate of 35. And we'll kind of let that run for a little bit here, but I would say definitely a little bit better results. The efficiency is a little bit better than some of the other miners. Got up to 270 on the efficiency there. You could see 36.40. For one of those hashes, so not bad. I mean, the card is still bouncing around a little bit with its hash rate, and sorry guys, here I'm kind of spacing out, but yeah, so definitely something to look at. Okay, this T-Rex miner, and I'm slightly more impressed than the other miners, but yeah, this is great competition. Okay, I'm liking what I'm seeing now. I'm seeing we've got a little fire lit underneath all these miner developers, and it's great to see. It's good competition, it's good for the community, and it's good for us miners, because we want that full hash rate. We want all the hash rate. We don't want to keep mining, you know, small hash rate with these light hash rate cards. And yeah, we really would like to switch back to Ethereum on these cards if we can. I know a lot of people are mining Raven and different coins with the LHR card. So it's good to see, And yeah, look at that, we're getting close to 30, we've just peaked 36 mega hash on there. And yeah, 222 at the wall. So yeah guys, I'm pretty happy with that. So just a recap again, check out the light hash rate from T-Rex Miner, and yeah, if you have a revision 2 or a revision 1 card, you know, pay attention to the arguments, and I know in Windows there's different arguments that can be set as well. So yeah, I'm gonna keep this video very to the point, guys. I hope those of you who are seeking information to do this in Hive OS have found what you need with my video. And yeah, again, I'm going to keep playing with this for a few days. In the comments, as always, guys, you've been phenomenal about, you know, giving me tips or advice, what has worked for you. So if you have a better idea what I could do for clocks to try to maximize or get even more hash rate as we're like approaching 37 mega hash there, let me know. I'm down to try that. But without further ado, we will cut the video here, guys. I hope everyone has a wonderful rest of the day, rest of the night, and we'll see you next time to do some more hash rate testing. Take care.